Hello friends, I am Ashwin. Today I will discuss the game played between Robert Byrne versus Bobby Fischer at US Chess Championship on 18th December 1963. This 21 move game won the Brilliancy Prize for Bobby Fischer. Bobby's opponent Robert started the game with pawn to d4. Now knight to f6, and this stops white from establishing classical center with this pawn to e4 move. Pawn to c4 was played, pawn to g6, pawn to g3, pawn to c6, and this claims this center for the black with the help of pawn to d5. Bishop to g2 was played, pawn to d5, c capture d5, and now knight to c3, bishop to g7, and pawn to e3 move. And this move is a bit weak move in my eye, because this weakens this light square significantly. Bobby just castled here, knight g2 e2, and now knight to c6. White just castled here, and here comes this b6. Black would like to develop his bishop either on a b7 or the a6, and similar with the white. White played this pawn to b3, and here comes this bishop to a6. This pins this knight on e2. Bishop to a3, which pins this pawn on e7. So Bobby played this rook to e8, queen to d2, and here comes a fantastic move, pawn to e5, which significantly weakens his d5 pawn. But in return, black gets a huge activity for his minor pieces. Pawn capture on e5, knight capture on e5 was played in the game. And here comes this rook f to d1, and which is considered to be a wrong rook, because this leaves the protection of this f2 square. Here the correct move for white is to play this rook a to d1, and white is just fine. But anyways, we have this rook f to d1 on the board, and now knight to d3, and black is threatening this knight to e4. That strengthens the position of this knight on d3. After knight capture, say on e4, pawn capture e4, black is having this fantastic knight on d3 square. But here, white just stopped this knight e4 idea with queen c2, and now knight e4 can't be possible because of this rook capture on d3, bishop capture on d3, and queen capture on d3, and it's white who is winning. But Bobby has something different in his mind. After queen to c2, he played this knight capture on f2, and now this proves that why this rook move, rook f to d1, was a wrong one. King capture on f2 force, and now comes this knight to g4 check. And here many possibilities. King f3 leads through checkmate in 4. King e1 is impossible due to this knight capture on e3, followed by this winning bishop on g2, which is just fine. I mean, winning 2 pawn. And if you play, say, king to f1, then this simple move wins the queen, knight capture e3. This forks the king, queen, rook, and bishop too, but this wins the queen, so nothing to analyze this. So the main move could be knight g4 and king g1, which was played in the game, but we'll see what happened in case of this king to f3. Then comes this rook capture on e3 check, and after king capture on g4, pawn to h5 check, and say king to h3, then this bishop to c8 leads to checkmate. Queen f5 force, and bishop capture f5 is just checkmate. So what are the possibilities for white to play? Is might be this king to f4, but this leads to this bishop to e5 check, and after king capture on g4, this bishop to c8, queen to f5, and bishop capture f5 is just checkmate. Therefore, after knight to g4, king to g1 was played, and here comes this knight capture on e3. This attacks this queen and the rook and the bishop. And here white thought might be that after queen to d2, black is going to capture this rook, but and then black would be having white would be having really great position. But here comes the Fischer's idea, and he captured this bishop. And now Fischer himself said that the king of white is at black's mercy. I mean, king capture on g2, and here comes this pawn to d4 using the light square. As you can see, this whole diagonal is totally weak. So bishop to b7 can be played, and queen d7 and queen to h3 is a very serious threat. Knight capture on d4 was played, and it comes bishop to b7 check, and knight to f3 is impossible due to this queen capture on d2 check, rook capture d2, and now bishop capture on c3 attacking both the rook. So say rook to d1, and then comes this bishop capture d2, rook capture d2, and now rook to e3, threatening to win this knight, and after this rook to f2 supporting the knight, black can play this rook to d8 with an idea of this rook to d3 winning this knight. If rook bishop to c1, then comes this rook capture f3, rook capture f3, and now rook to just d3 wins this rook full. So at the end, black is having an extra rook, so this is completely winning. So after this bishop to b7 check, white played this king to f1, and which is forced. If you play say king to g1, which leads to a very strong attack with this bishop capture d4 check, queen capture d4, and now this rook to e1. So in case of rook capture e1, black can just win the queen on d4. So say king to f2, but then comes this queen capture on d4, rook capture on d4, followed by rook capture on a1, and black is having an exchange plus an extra pawn. So this position is completely winning for black. Therefore, after this bishop to b7 check, white played this king to f1, and here comes this queen to d7, and white resigned. Fischer himself write that a better disappointment. I had hoped for this queen f2 move, where Fischer can just play this queen h3 check, and after king g1, this rook e1, fantastic move, and now queen capture e1 is impossible due to this checkmate threat on g2. So say rook capture on e1, and there comes this bishop capture on d4, and black is winning the queen. So friends, how was the video? I hope you did enjoy it. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.